Hello everyone, and welcome to a video that's a little different than the usual. Today, I'm doing a review of four Steam Deck docks, but this won't be any ordinary review. I'm bringing data to back everything up. Stay tuned to see what comes in the box, a physical overview, I/O throughput, networking benchmarks, and display latency testing. So, who are the contenders? We have the official Steam Deck dock by Valve, model number 2001. iVoler's 6-in-1 dock, model number SD02A. NYXI's 8-in-1 dock, model number V255. And the JSAUX or JSAUX M.2 docking station, model number HB0604. For the record, the official dock was purchased by me. The iVoler and NYXI docks were provided to me for review, and the JSAUX dock was a gift from a friend with no expectation of review. No money has changed hands, and the companies have zero influence in what I say. Each non-official dock has an affiliate link in the description below if you're interested in them and want to support the channel though. Lastly, this is a completely new type of content for me, but I wanted to give it a try. Let me know if you like it in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. With the business out of the way, let's get into a very brief look into what comes with each dock and a physical overview. The official dock, with a price of $89, comes with the dock itself and a standard Steam Deck charging brick. As for the dock itself, it's made of a black plastic and comes in at only 120 grams, or 4.2 ounces. It looks fairly robust, but mine appears to have been used prior to me receiving it, with a small mark near a USB port and dust covering the whole dock. Regardless, it's small and light enough to bring basically anywhere, and it's a lot more portable than the standard Switch dock, for example. The only inputs are on the back, with DisplayPort 1.4, HDMI 2.0, USB-C power in, a gigabit RJ45 port, and three USB 3.1 Type-A ports. There's not much to say about the inputs other than that the USB ports are very close together and some larger connectors could cause interference with one another. Next up is the iVoler 6-in-1 dock, which retails for $56. It only comes with the dock and no real accessories to speak of. The dock is made of a sturdy-feeling aluminum alloy and weighs about 200 grams, or 7 ounces. It's very sturdy, has some rubberized grips to keep the deck in place, and has some minimal branding on the front. The branding isn't too bad, but I would have liked to see the front of the dock blank. It has all of its ports on the back, with a gigabit RJ45, HDMI 2.0, USB-C power input, and three USB 3.0 Type-A ports. The USB ports are a step down from what the official dock offers with USB 3.0 instead of 3.1, and no DisplayPort at all. However, the USB ports are spaced out much further on the iVoler dock, so larger USB connectors can be used comfortably. Thirdly, we have the NYXI 8-in-1 dock, which retails for $69, and apparently comes with a carrying case, silicone cover, screen protector, and trackpad skins, but mine only came with the dock in my box. The dock is made of a high-quality aluminum alloy and feels solid, but it is pretty weighty at 295 grams or 10.4 ounces. It has a silicone sticker that shrouds the entire surface that contacts the deck, so it feels very safe, but it might be too tight when using a case on the deck. The branding on my unit didn't seem to match the promotional material, with a large font on the top, hidden when the deck is present. The front has NYXI's small owl logo, which is okay as logos go. Both sides of the dock have inputs, with the right side having a D-sub VGA connector, and the left having a gigabit RJ45 port. The back of the dock has USB-C power input, HDMI 2.0, DisplayPort 1.2, and three USB 3.0 ports. The ports on the NYXI dock are interesting to say the least. It has the same three well-spaced USB 3.0 ports as the iVoler dock, but also has a DisplayPort 1.2 port, which is a major step down from the official dock's 1.4 port. Then, we have the out-of-left-field port inclusion, the VGA port. I tested it, and it worked fine, and I can actually see it being useful for some system admins since rack-mounted displays often have VGA connections, but for the average user, it's pretty puzzling. Lastly, we have the JSAUX M.2 dock, which retails for $109. They also offer models including a 1 terabyte or 2 terabyte drive, which sells for $190 and $260 respectively. All three options also come with a 65-watt power brick with a 3-meter or 10-foot cable. I was sent the 1 terabyte model, for which I'd like to thank JSAUX profusely, but I'd like to reiterate that there was no expectation of a review whatsoever. The dock is made of very high-quality aluminum, and the surfaces feel well-machined. It weighs in at 310 grams, or 10.9 ounces, which is the heaviest of any of the docks we'll be reviewing today, and it has a massive footprint compared to the official dock to accommodate for the M.2 drive. Ports on the JSAUX dock are mostly on the rear, with a USB-C power input, HDMI 2.0, and 2 USB Type-A ports. As an oddity, the dock and promotional art list the speed as USB 3.2, but the specifications on the JSAUX site list USB 3.0. I'll be benchmarking the speed later, so stay tuned to see that. Looking from the front of the dock, the left side has a gigabit RJ45 port, and the right side has a very small indent, which makes this dock very special. Lift up on it and the top of the dock will pop up, revealing space for an M.2 port with spacing up to the full 2280 length. Just for reference, it's M and B keyed, which supports both PCIe and SATA drives. As you can see here, my dock came with a Lexar NM610 Pro, which is rated for 3300 megabytes per second reads and 2600 megabytes per second writes. This doesn't matter a whole lot for reasons we'll touch on later, but it is good to know. All testing will be done with the M.2 present, since that's how most users are likely to use such an expensive dock. With the physical review of the docks done, let's move on to something much more interesting: benchmarks. For this section, I want to start by saying that I don't have purpose-built equipment for these tests, but I have done my very best to get valuable data that should give an indicator of real-world performance. All of the networking tests were done with a brand new, but tested, Cat6 cable. One end of the cable was attached directly to the motherboard on my gaming PC, while the other was connected directly to the dock being tested. Both sides were set with completely static networking, so there would be no flapping while looking for DHCP. With that disclaimer out of the way, my first round of tests is on network throughput. First, we're testing TCP. TCP is how most programs besides games communicate with the internet. You can see here that the JSAUX dock had the lowest average throughput at about 940 megabits per second. It was also the least stable throughput, while all the others roughly tied in both of those results. To be clear, all of these results being within a few megabits of one another likely wouldn't be noticed by most users, unless you have a 1 gigabit connection and were watching graphs. This test is clearly a three-way tie between NYXI, iVoler, and the official dock. Next up, we're testing UDP, which is the standard protocol for games. We can see that the average throughput is higher, which is to be expected, but the JSAUX dock manages to be very slightly slower and much less consistent than the other docks. This could be related to the M.2 drive being present, but is still noteworthy. All of the other docks were pretty similar once again, so this test is a three-way tie. Nextly, let's move on to network latency testing. So you've probably noticed the absolute nightmare of a chart. Why is it this way? Well, immediately after testing the network throughput for the official dock, it started dropping almost 70% of all packets. Essentially, 7 out of 10 messages sent to the internet started getting lost for seemingly no reason. I tried forcing a firmware update, every troubleshooting step online, leaving it disconnected for a long time, leaving the power unplugged, different cables, different networks, everything. Unfortunately, it remains in this state now, and I can't use the Ethernet port on my official dock any longer. As I mentioned in the physical review, my dock looked slightly used. I hope this is a fluke and not something that's happened to others, but I couldn't put in for a replacement before this video needed to go live. As a result, I've removed the official dock from the next graph. All other functions remain intact, so it'll be back in the next test. With that out of the way, here we can see the network latency in milliseconds. The iVoler dock is by far the fastest, while the JSAUX dock is the most consistent, barring a single major outlier. The times we're seeing here are very, very small, and you're likely to have delays dozens of times larger than this going to the local ISP, but iVoler is definitely the winner in this test. Next up is I/O throughput. This test was done by plugging an SSD in the USB port of each dock. The SSD was formatted as EXT4 to minimize overhead and is capable of reading and writing at about 520 megabytes per second when connected directly to a USB 3.2 port. As you can see here, the NYXI, iVoler, and official docks all have very similar results, right around the 380 to 390 megabytes per second range. The JSAUX dock, however, averages a full 100 megabytes per second faster than any contenders and is absolutely the winner here. As a side note, I believe that the website is incorrect about the JSAUX USB speed. It seems that the version printed on the dock itself is more accurate, but still slightly misleading. These seem to be USB 3.2x1 ports, previously known as USB 3.1, operating at 5 gigabits per second. Nextly, we have input latency testing. This testing was done by connecting each dock directly to a 60 Hz monitor using HDMI, since it's the port most likely to be used by the most people. I set the resolution to 720p and enabled allow tearing to remove as much latency as possible, and then booted up Celeste. Celeste is a very fast-paced game with very accurate inputs, with an art style that allows me to see the exact frame an input is taken, which is why it was chosen. I then recorded the screen and the dock with a 240fps camera on my phone, and pressed the jump button 5 times at odd intervals. Lastly, I cross-referenced the video and audio to find the exact moments I pressed the button and the input was accepted, then averaged the results from each dock. And here's where we can see the official dock really shines. With an average response time of 21.76 milliseconds, which is pretty close to the 16.67 milliseconds of a single frame, it's definitely the winner here and a must for quick gameplay. The iVoler dock comes in pretty closely in second, with the NYXI and JSAUX docks being roughly 2 entire frames behind. For the final section of testing, I wanted to test the speed of the M.2 SSD in the JSAUX dock, while being connected to an external display at 1080p, since I felt like this would be a very common configuration for the dock itself. For this test, I just used KDiskMark, since it can simulate reads and writes much better than I can with my current resources. As we can see, the sequential reads and writes hover around 900 megabytes per second, whereas the random reads and writes with a queue of 32 are around 128, and the single queue randoms are 40 on write and 69 on read. The sequential reads and writes come fairly close to the theoretical 1.2 gigabyte per second maximum of the dock's USB 3.2x2 interface, which is incredibly impressive considering it's also handling a 1080p video signal. So that's great, but how do we know if that's fast? Well, here are the results from the stock drive of a 512GB Steam Deck. The writes are pretty close, with the internal drive only managing about 300MB per second over the JSAUX drive. The reads on the internal drive, however, are almost 2.5 times the speed of the JSAUX drive. But, and this is a huge but, let's look at the speeds of my microSD so we can tell how they compare. As you can see, the JSAUX drive absolutely puts the microSD to shame. This is no surprise since I'm not using a top-rated microSD, but even if I was, the dock's drive would outclass it by several times. So, would I recommend using the drive then? Yes. If you're docked, performance on the JSAUX M.2 is huge, and I couldn't tell a difference during gameplay between the JSAUX dock and the internal drive. It also allows you to store games that you'd normally only play on a larger screen, without having to swap microSDs or fill up the deck itself. I could imagine it being a massive boon for emulation. Alright, with all the testing out of the way, where does that leave us? Well, here's a recap. The official dock has fast USB ports, will have support for VRR and MST in a future update, and has a rock-bottom input latency of only 22 milliseconds. It also has the smallest footprint and is incredibly light, making it perfect for throwing in a backpack. Unfortunately, mine is completely unable to do basic networking anymore, and I'm unsure if it's a firmware issue or a quality control issue. It also came to me looking used, so it's possible that it was an RMA that wasn't handled properly. It has a fairly high asking price of $89 for just the dock and power adapter, which might be a bit pricey for some. The official dock is what I consider the ideal travel dock. It's tiny, has good inputs, and the plastic won't scratch up other devices in your bag. The iVoler 6-in-1 dock was the cheapest in the review today at only $56. It was the overall winner in the networking tests and came in second place for input latency. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a DisplayPort output, and the USB ports are fairly limited, but it's hard to beat at the price. The iVoler dock is an amazing value for what you get, and if you're worried about network performance, it's the clear winner. The NYXI 8-in-1 dock was the second cheapest at $69, and it also had the widest variety of connections. It has basically whatever video output you might need, including VGA, and has decent showings in all of the networking tests. On the negative side of things, the input latency was second worst with 32 milliseconds, and the USB ports are of the slower variety. The NYXI dock definitely feels like a specialty product. I'm not sure if any of you are still gaming on an old CRT, but this is the way to go if you are. The JSAUX M.2 dock was the most expensive by far, starting at $109. It had a smaller variety of connections, but the full-size M.2 port is super unique, and I love how seamlessly and toollessly it can be changed. The included drive is very fast, but the other functions suffer for it. The networking was the slowest of the bunch, and the input latency was the worst with a full 34 milliseconds until an input was mirrored on screen. The JSAUX dock would be perfect for a living room TV, where you might want to keep party games or emulators offloaded to the dock. It's really hard to decide which dock I'd go with if I could only get one. What do you guys think? Leave a comment below telling me which you'd pick, and don't forget there are affiliate links below for the non-official docks. I'd like to thank iVoler and NYXI again for sending me docs to review, and JSAUX for the absolutely amazing care package. Thank you to my patrons for allowing me to test out cool content that I've always wanted to try. Verge4469, Mitch, AzeroFail, Frankie Odgers, Lemon, Brian D, Yi Luo, Pai K, Madam Slug, Spiffman, Bradley C, The Duck, Jean Cliche, Jimmy Champagne, Christopher Comer, Keenan Brody, Mario Diaz, Chase Melancon, DevOps D Adams, Larry, Nathan Wilkie, Rafaniak ZX, Aiden, Montana CB7, Shane Duncan, Cam Leavenworth, Kazab FZ, Samuel McConan, Joseph Pizza, Yvonne P, Vic, Quarantined Gambler, GameDev50, Nick Breckens, Miosos, Spolt, and Anon9001. And thank you to my YouTube members, Eugene Brednev, VV, Prashid Shah, The Wildcat, and Papa Juicy. Lastly, thank you to Didier Vink and Benjamin Spence for donating with a super thanks. Thank you all for watching, and have a great day.